matches, going the full distance. It really has been an incredible day so far. And I'm very much looking forward to our last match of the day, the men's singles, Chou Tien Chen of Chinese Taipei against the unseeded Ajay Jayaram of India. First semi-final for over 3 years for Ajay Jayaram. Of course, it's the second semi-final in 2 weeks for Chou Tien Chen. Looking at the destination Dubai Super Series standings, well, Chou Tien Chen, by virtue of his semi-final last week in Tokyo, moved up 3 places into the top 10, as you can see. But there's already the 2 Indian players in that top 10, so it really does reflect how well India is doing, the fact that Ajay Jayaram is in this semi-final. Of course, Momoto and Yano Jorgensen changed places, and that's because Jorgensen wasn't able to compete in Japan. He wasn't able to compete here either. And despite all his efforts, Victor Axelsen reaching the final in Tokyo remained at number 4 on those Super Series standings. So looking at the men's singles draw, well, in the top half of the draw, you can see the defending champion, Chen Long, the world champion, safely through. But it was quite extraordinary when you look at that. The other player in the top half, Momota, well, between Chen Long and Momota, they've won 5 of the 7 Super Series events so far this year. Bottom half of the draw, Chou Tien Chen, the only seed left by the end of day one. And there is the 25-year-old from Taipei. Ajay Jayaram, 27. Tomorrow, he'll turn 28. Wouldn't it be a fairy tale if Ajay Jayaram could be through to the final and celebrate his birthday by playing the first ever Super Series tournament final, as far as he's concerned. That's a nice touch, the warm shake of the hands between the two players. Gilles Gavert from France, the rempart for this one. Fricots from the Netherlands will be the service judge. Of course, this man has won a Super Series title, the French Open, last year. For Ajay Jayaram, well, it's been a long 3-year wait, battling injury problems after injury problems. But that just shows what a wonderful character he is, to come back from all those troubles and once again be in the elite tier on semi-finals day. The world number 7 has been 1 place higher. And as we just saw, number 10 on the Super Series standings. Prior to this year, he's making his 5th appearance here. He's never been beyond the first round. A couple of times he's lost in the qualifying. But he's had a good year. He reached the final of the Chinese Taipei Grand Prix Gold. But he had to battle in the first 2 rounds here. First of all, against Pranoy of India. Came from a game down, 1 hour and 3 minutes, as you can see. And then against the veteran, Boon Sak Ponsana of Thailand. He was very impressive yesterday against the left-handed Tian Hao Wei. 2 straight games. Well, if you were with us yesterday, you would have enjoyed watching Ajay Jayaram in his match yesterday against the left-handed Sho Sasaki. So both of them had left-handers yesterday. Well, as far as the Indian player is concerned, he's down 1 place in the world ranking this week to number 32. And he, like his opponent prior to this year, had never got past the first round of the Korean Open. He's only making his 3rd appearance here. But he's had 2 matches that have gone the full distance. His easiest match was in the first round against the number 6 seed, Victor Axelsen, who I have to say looked a little bit jaded after reaching the final in Japan. But that's to take nothing away from Ajay Jayaram's performance in beating him. But then three games against Wong Wing Ki of Hong Kong and three games yesterday, as I say, against Sho Sasaki. Hour and 6 minutes yesterday. So this will be the fifth meeting between these two players. And on the previous four occasions that they've met, and there's been two wins apiece. There we are, that's confirmation of that. The last time that they played was earlier this year, US Grand Prix Gold of 2015. In fact, Chou Tien Chen has won the last two occasions that they've played against each other. Carver and Fried Cox are court officials for this one.
Gentlemen, on my right, Ajay Jayaram, India. And on my left, Chou Tien Chen, Chinese Taipei. Ajay Jayaram to serve, level play.
So the last semi-final here at the Victor Korea Open.
It's over.
Getting underway.
One, love.
Chou Tien Chen, the number seven seed. Nearest to us, unseeded Ajay Jayaram. Good judgment from Jayaram.
One all.
Two very, very nice personalities on court.
Two, one.
This man, delightful racket skills, easy, relaxed hitting style. And already you can see the sheer physicality of this man. Powerful mover, strong legs. And that's a very good smash as well. Decision. He took that backhand very late. Look at that, that shoulder height. Can't afford to take it that late.
Wait, please. Thank you.
has landed
service
in.
Service over. 5-4.
Oh, Chou Tien Chen had such an incredible home event this year. Chinese Taipei Grand Prix gold. Lost in three games in the final to the world champion Chen Long, but in the quarterfinal had beaten the world number two Jorgensen, and in the semi-final beat the Olympic champion Lin Dan. He looks to me as if he's a little bit nervous at the start of this semi-final, his fourth Super Series tournament semi-final. This one out to delightful net shot from Ajay Jayaram yesterday. How many times did he play an outright winner with that against Sho Sasaki?
Over.
The luck of the net cord, for which he immediately apologises. Trains at the Prakash Bhattacharya Academy in Bangalore. Decision from Ajay Jayaram, costing him dear. He really is developing as a player, Chou Tien Chen. When I think back a couple of years, the first time I really took notice of him was actually 5 years ago in the China Masters Super Series. And he was a game way up against Chen Jin, who was the then world champion. Chen Jin actually retired. 16-8 up.
Seven.
I thought, crikey, who is this? Chou Tien Chen. He's got huge potential. He seems to be improving. An awful lot of shots with that.
8-10.
Quick serve goes long,
11,
though,
8,
and it means that Ajay Jayaram has the advantage at the mid-game interval. 3-point advantage. Just 7 minutes to the mid-game interval.
Thank you, coach.
So both sets of coaches take leave of the court.
There you go, some play.
Indian fans.
Service
Mets. I remember last year when he won the French Super Series. Completed the Grand Slam as far as Chinese Taipei is concerned. They had players winning all five disciplines at Super Series level. I thought he could take the shuttle a little higher when he comes forward to the net. He's certainly doing that nowadays. Level. And Jayaram doesn't panic with these long rallies. And I think he knows that his opponent has got such an explosive attacking style. And he feels he's got to counteract that. We didn't see much attacking from Jayaram. Yesterday, well, there's a challenge here.
Challenge called out.
It's difficult to make a challenge at the far side of the court. Can't really see it properly. Players have to sort of judge from the way they hit it, but there is so much drift in this arena. One will tell from this angle. Here we go. Hawkeye will tell us, and it is in. That's a great challenge. My goodness me.
12-11.
Four straight points since the mid-game interval. Retrieving. It's gone long. 14-11. Explosive attacking style suddenly from nowhere from that base position. He just leaps. Look at that. He wasn't even at the base position. He was nearer the front of the court and leapt to play that thunderous smash. So six straight points since the mid-game interval. With that. Desai was teasing the Indian coaches the other day. I have utmost respect for them both, Madhu and Gopichand. And AJ Jayaram was 11-10 up against Wong-Wing Kee in the second round, and from leading at the mid-game interval, lost the next 9 points. He hasn't lost the next 9 points here, but similar sort of a situation. That was seven straight points after the mid-game interval.
Fifteen.
Semifinals. It's incredible leg strength to jump from that base position. We saw it to the round the head shot and the round the head smash just a moment ago there from the forehand side. But he's pushed it long. There, going with the drift. 14-16. Yeah, quite a long way long too. That Ajay Jayaram can just scramble the shuttle back, the more frustrated I think Chou Tien Chen will become, because he does have such an explosive attack. If it's not winning points, he might begin to get a little frustrated. Level. Yeah, there's Madhu and Gopi. Gopi Chand and Madhu Mitalish. Struggling at the moment to control the lifts, pushes from the net.
Service over,
17-18. Fabulous net shot from Jayaram. I told you he had good skills and good touch. That's amazing. Oh, good flick serve too. Oh, we were watching the 19, previous rally. Oh, good flick serve. Six of the last 7 points to the Indian player. Oh my goodness! Indecision from Jayaram.
19.
I have to say, it was an amazing lift from Chou Tien Chen. Yet again, it was a wonderful net shot that would force the high, high lift. Oh, look at that defence. Well, I was talking about it during the doubles, wasn't I? Defensive shots turned across court. So two game point opportunities for Jayaram. Courage to leave 19, that one. 20. Oh, he's done it again. This time it was a miss hit, but the intention was clear and the intention was good. Opening game to the unseeded AJ Jayaram, 21-19 in 19 minutes. What a start for the unseeded player. Seven seed Chou Tien Chen doing response. Coaches taking leave of the court. Now it's down to the players.
Second game.
Will Chou Tien Chen respond? Now he's shown great character since a disastrous World Championships. Disastrous for him. Number six seed lost in the very first round. Bounce back, next tournament, Japan last week, reached the semi-final. Semi-final here. They always say the test of a true champion is the way they fight back. Oh, that's good play. Attacking style from this end of the court, hitting with the drift. And of course, the attacking play more potent. Sound quite right. Thought a string had gone. Yeah, the grip powder there just makes the grip a little bit tacky, and therefore it's easier to change the grip midway through the rally. Change the grip, I mean the way you're holding the racket. It's different.
One, three, play.
For a lot of shots. To that is getting behind the shuttle. Fast movement back. Look, he played the net shot. Had to move all the way back in court. And to be able to get behind it like that to play the smash is quite remarkable. at Ajay Jayaram, proving that he too is fleet of foot. It's a great lift. Disguise on the drop shot. And Jayaram could have played that. Thought it was going wide. It goes down as a misjudgment. Yeah, look, he's in good position. I do like the way he keeps his center of gravity so low. Movement, move low, hit high. Oh dear me. Yeah. I couldn't really hear that. Lila Gopichand, bound to be words of wisdom. He's a fabulous coach, great understanding of the game. Oh, that's nice. Oh, brilliantly played. Well-constructed rally by Ajay Jayaram. Well, we saw it yesterday, the disguise on the forehand net shot, just proving he's got disguise today on the backhand net shot. And then ready to pounce on the next one. That is terrific. He's pushed it long.
Service over. 7-6.
I think the drift not quite as pronounced as it was earlier on in the day. Singles with Akane Yamaguchi. In our third match today, I thought all the matches last week in reaching the final took its toll in the end. I wonder if the all the matches last week for Chou Tien Chen is beginning to take its toll here today. Quite frankly, I don't think it was anything to do with the legs in that last rally. It was just great skill from Jayaram, taking that off the top of the tape. Oh, good defense. Yeah. Well, to me, Jayaram is beginning to control the front of the court. He's taking the shuttle much higher on the net shots. Look at that. And again, he's the one at the net first. And he's opened up a 4-point cushion here in this second game.
10-6, play.
That's good. Yeah. What a difference when Chou Tien Chen stretches out that racket arm and takes the shuttle early at the net. He's got options. And in that last rally, the little hold and flick was superb. Jayaram, as in the opening game, will have the advantage at the mid-game interval. But here in the second game, it will be a 4-point advantage rather than the 3-point advantage he had in the first. Tales come true.
20 seconds.
Thank you, coach. Well, I don't believe at the beginning of the week he thought he could potentially be celebrating his birthday by playing the final of the Korean
11,
Open.
7, play.
But he's just 10 points away from doing so. Very good play. And you see Chou Tien Chen in full flow like that, taking the shuttle early. It's awesome. Great follow-up. Spell after the mid-game interval of the opening game, did the man from Taipei. Oh, that's a great smash.
12-9.
He's played several cross court earlier on in this match, therefore mixing it up, going straight down the line. Clever tactics.
Service over. 10-12.
patient build-up in that rally from Chou Tien Chen. Tremendous.
12-0.
And he's back level. Having been 4 points adrift at the mid-game interval. 5 of the last 6 points.
Thank you. Ajay. Play, please.
That's another good rally. Oh, phenomenal smash. That's unbelievable. What a good rally. 6 of the last 7 points now. Look at that. Threading it down the line. Oh, the umpire's going to have a word with them, taking too much time in between points. Yep, stop walking around. I'm glad the umpires are being a little stricter on that. Play is supposed to be continuous. It's gone long.
14-12.
7 of the last 8 points now. There from Jayaram. Oh, that's a good return of serve. Oh, heavenly.
Service over. 13,
to play a skill
14.
Shot like that. That is magnificent. Don't know how on earth he found that angle on that last shot. It was brilliant. Yeah.
14.
Well.
Oh.
Doesn't have the same sort of dynamic, explosive movement, but.
Thank you.
Still has the power.
Wait, please.
14 all.
So it's over. 15-14.
Really has played the net well, has AJ. well. Oh my goodness.
16-15.
Oh, I said he was playing the net well. That was extraordinary. Perfect net shot.
17.
AJ Jayaram. Look at that. Stretching forward, lunging towards the net. And that's the longest rally of the match so far. An attempted kill from Chou Tien Chen. Look at that. Just calmly plays it back into court, AJ Jayaram. And 3 points away from a place in his first ever final of a Super Series event. That's wide. And now just two tantalizing points. And a run of five straight points. Both players taking their time. There was no doubt it was wide. Oh, well, I can't believe there was a challenge on that.
Challenge unsuccessful. Chou Tien Chen, one challenge remaining.
No, I was so sure I was already calling that there was only two 19, points needed by AJ Jayaram.
Play.
Well, match point opportunities.
Match point, 15.
Five of them, to be precise, for the unseeded AJ Jayaram.
Game.
He's missed it, and AJ Jayaram is through to his first ever final at a Super Series event. 21-19, 21-15 in 44 minutes. That is incredible. He's going to have one heck of a birthday tomorrow when he turns 28. What a way to celebrate a birthday. Congratulated by his coaches. What a tournament he's had, and what a welcome return from all the injury problems and all the heartache. He is through to the final, where he will meet Chen Long, the defending champion, world number one and world champion. Well, obvious disappointment for Chou Tien Chen, but I suspect that after last week where he reached the semi-final. Today he looked a little fatigued to me. But as I say, take nothing away from the victory by Ajay Jayaram. 21-19, 21-15 in 44 minutes. Finals day at the Victor Career Open. It all started with that men's doubles, and that really set the tone for the day. The world number ones, Lee Yong Dae and Yu Young Sung, coming through in an hour and 39 minutes against the defending champions and two-time winners of this Korean Open, Bo and Mogensen from Denmark. Then we had the mixed doubles and the three-time winners, the world and Olympic champions, Jiang Nang and Zhao Yunlei. They needed three games as well against Go Sung-hyung and Kim Ha-na of Korea. Well, then the women's singles, Sung Ji-hyung, who won the title 2 years ago. In fact, she's been in two previous finals, 2010 as well. Tomorrow, she will contest a third Korean Open final because she beat the world junior champion Akane Yamaguchi in an hour and 10 minutes in three thrilling games. Then it was the women's doubles and the Asian Games gold medalists from Indonesia, Maswari and Polly, beating last year's beaten finalists. So the Indonesians through to their first final here as a pair. That was an hour and 29 minutes. And as we've just seen, the men's singles, the only semi-final here on court number one not to go the full distance. And Ajay Jayaram, who will celebrate his 28th birthday tomorrow, has defeated another seed, Chou Tien Chen, on his way through to his first ever Super Series tournament final. Well, of course, we will be back with all finals action same time tomorrow. That's 12 o'clock local time, midday. That's 0300 GMT. From all of us here in Seoul, until tomorrow, especially from me, Jill Clark, we'll see you tomorrow for finals. Bye for now.
It's over.